Hi guys, today I'm trying a new product. I'm trying the Holbein acrylic gouache. This is something that I've been curious to try for a really long time because I've seen a lot of people use it and I've done a bit of research into it and I have an idea in mind of what they'll be like. So I've been curious to know if it is what I think it'll be like. So I finally went out and bought some and today I'm going to talk about my first impressions of them and what I think about them. The first thing that I did and what I always do when I get new paints is I swatch out all of the colours. You guys are probably sick of seeing me swatch colours by now since I feel like I've done it a lot on this channel, but I do think it's really important to swatch out your colours when you get them because you want to be able to know what they look like on paper. And after I swatch out the colours, I always just stick them to my wall. So I have this wall just covered in lots of colour swatches and this just helps me to become more familiar with the colours that I have, and when I need to refer to them, they're just right in front of me on my wall. So just then I painted a black strip using the black acrylic gouache so that I could test the opaqueness of the paints at the same time. So if you don't know what acrylic gouache is, I basically think of it as a hybrid between acrylic paint and traditional gouache. It has the properties of gouache in the sense that it has a matte finish and you can dilute the paint with water and work in thin washes and build it up into an opaque consistency. But at the same time, it also has the properties of acrylic because instead of using gum arabic as the binder, which is what is used in traditional gouache, acrylic gouache uses an acrylic resin binder, which means that once the paint is dry on the paper or on your palette, it can't be reactivated with water, just like acrylic paint. I chose to try Holbein acrylic gouache for a few reasons. Firstly, because I saw a lot of positive reviews about them online, so I was quite sure I would have a positive experience with using them. Secondly, they were available in my local art store, so it was really convenient for me to buy them. And if you're from Melbourne, I'll leave a link down below which store I bought it from, since it's not always easy to source art supplies here in Australia. And thirdly, these are artist quality paints. When I was deciding what colours and how many colours to buy, I decided to limit myself to mostly just the primaries because that way it forces me to practice my colour mixing and to study colour theory more. I'll show you how I colour mix to get the most out of this somewhat limited palette, but before I do that, I'd like to thank the sponsor of today's video, which is Skillshare. Skillshare is an amazing online learning platform with thousands of classes for creative and curious people who want to learn new skills. They have classes on a really broad range of topics. Whether you're interested in learning how to paint or design or edit videos, they probably have a class on there, if not many, many classes on the topic. I recently needed to learn a bit of Photoshop to help me edit my paintings to be made ready for making postcards and prints. So I turned to Skillshare and I found this really great class by Dylan Miswinski, digitizing your paint, selecting and adjusting artwork in Photoshop. And what I love about her class is that it's really concise and guides you through the process of how she digitizes her artwork in Photoshop, and she shows you all of her tricks on how she does it. I also started learning gouache on Skillshare and the classes were really helpful in getting me started in learning a new medium, and since then I've seen that they've launched so many more classes just on the topic of gouache. They're always launching new premium classes across all of the topics and it's less than $10 a month on an annual subscription. If you are interested in trying the platform, the first 1,000 people to use the link in my description will get a free trial of Skillshare premium membership. So I'll just show you guys how I experimented with the 7 tubes of paint that I had to try and get the most out of them, and I'll just share some of the knowledge that I have on colour theory that helps me to feel quite comfortable painting with just the primaries. First, I mixed up a black using ultramarine blue and burnt umber. If you want more of a cool black, you can mix in more ultramarine blue, and if you want more of a warm black, you can mix in more burnt umber. Then I compared it to the primary black fresh out of the tube, and the black that I managed to mix was a little bit lighter, but this just goes to show that I actually can work without having black at all. Next, I wanted to see what kind of purples I could mix. So I chose primary magenta because I wanted a cool red, because I knew that it would help me to mix more vibrant purples. If you choose a warmer red, you'll get purples that are more dull. So I mixed the primary magenta with the cerulean blue, and that gave me quite a nice purple already. Then I mixed the primary magenta with the ultramarine blue, and I could mix an even more vibrant purple. I also mix in some white to see what kind of pastel shades I can get, and then I mix in more blue to see if I can get more of a blue toned purple. Next up, I wanted to see what kind of oranges I could mix. I only had the cool lemon yellow and the cool primary magenta, so I mixed those together, and then I also just adjusted it by adding more yellow for more of a brighter orange, and then adding more of the primary magenta for more of a peachy pinkish orange color. So you can just play around like that and see what kind of shades and hues you can get just with those few colors that you have. My rule when it comes to buying more colors is that it should be purely for convenience purposes. Otherwise, if you use a lot of pre-mixed colors, then you're missing out on the opportunity to learn more about color theory. As a beginner, I really struggled to paint from reference photos because I didn't know how to mix the colors I saw. I was used to only using pre-mixed colors, so if the color in the reference photo was just a little bit different, I didn't know how to tweak the paints I had to match that color. So I think it's really important to teach yourself color theory before you start playing around with lots of pre-mixed colors. Now let's take a look at what greens I could mix. So the reason I chose a lemon yellow is because I wanted a cool yellow that would help me to mix really vibrant greens. So I mixed a lemon yellow with the cerulean blue, and that gave me a really bright green, and then I just adjusted it by adding more blue or adding more yellow to see what other kind of shades I could get. And then I mixed the ultramarine blue with the lemon yellow, which gave me a much more dull green, but this is also a really natural looking green, so that's going to be really useful. One thing I forgot to show here is mixing black and yellow gives a really nice olive green, and I often mix the two if I want to mix a natural looking green. So here's just a quick demo of some of the colors that I could mix just with the 7 tubes of paint. You could definitely have less than what I have and still be able to mix up a lot of colors. For my first painting with acrylic gouache, I decided to paint a field of sunflowers. I specifically chose this because the thing I was most looking forward to with using acrylic gouache is the fact that if I lay down a dark color, I can continue to lay light colors on top without having to worry about it reactivating the layer underneath and muddying those lighter colors on top. So I thought a field of sunflowers would be a good chance to test this out, since the sunflowers are a really light color. And in the past, when I've painted sunflowers, I've tried to, instead of laying down a dark background first, I actually paint the sunflowers and then go and paint the background in between all of it, which is a little bit tedious. And I've also tried it the other way, where I paint the background first and then I have to be really, really careful when I'm painting the sunflowers on top. Otherwise, they will muddy with the darker color underneath. So let's talk about my first impressions of acrylic gouache once I started painting with it. I've actually been really hesitant to try acrylic gouache, even though I've been curious to know what it's like. I was hesitant for one main reason. Before I discovered traditional gouache, I had only really painted with acrylics. I always had a few issues with acrylics, mainly that it would dry too quickly and it would dry on my brush and it would ruin my brushes after a few uses. I couldn't find a way to take care of my brushes well, which meant that a lot of the times they would lose that natural shape and I wouldn't be able to paint those fine details that I like to paint when I'm working with gouache. So when I started using gouache, I immediately fell in love with the fact that you could re-wet the paint on your palette, and if the paint dried in your brushes, you could easily wash it out, and I could keep all of my brushes in a really great condition as though they were new. I found it really hard to switch back to acrylics and to enjoy using it. Every time I tried, I would try to use it like I do traditional gouache. So I was worried that when I tried acrylic gouache, I would have those same frustrations of it ruining my brushes or it drying too quickly on the paper or drying on my palette. I basically went in with the mindset that I would use this acrylic gouache like I do traditional gouache, but once the paint was dry, it would dry water resistant and I wouldn't be able to rework it. So it would also dry on my palette and I wouldn't be able to reuse that paint. And the only way I could think to combat that was to use my spray bottle a lot. My other expectation before trying acrylic gouache was that the values wouldn't change as much from wet to dry. So what you get out of the tube and what you put on your paper when it's wet should be the same value as when it's dry. For some reason, I feel like that's not the case. I feel like the darker values still dry lighter and the lighter values still dry darker. But I've watched a lot of videos and they've all said that the acrylic gouache dries the same value. So I'm not sure if it's just me. Maybe I just need to use it a bit more. So if you've never painted with acrylics and you've only tried gouache before, then I would say acrylic gouache is pretty much gouache, but it dries water resistant. If you have never tried gouache and you've only painted with acrylics, then you can imagine acrylic gouache as a soft body acrylic that dries matte and more opaque if you're not diluting it with water. You can also thin it down with water and work with it in thin washes. And because you can thin it down with water, you can get more of a flow of paint across the paper as opposed to acrylics. The paint usually doesn't travel as far. One difference that I noted between traditional gouache and acrylic gouache is that with acrylic gouache, you can have thinner layers of paint on top. Since it doesn't matter if the paint on top is more runny, it's not going to re-wet the layer from underneath since that's already dried water resistant. Whereas with traditional gouache, I'm always making sure that the next layer I put is a little bit thicker, otherwise it will disturb that layer underneath, which is something that I talked about in my common beginner gouache mistakes video. So when I was painting these sunflowers, I kind of had the temptation to keep thinning down my paint so it would spread further. And I think that's also because I felt like the acrylic gouache didn't run as smoothly across the page as traditional gouache did. So it did take a little bit of getting used to. I had to watch my control of water, otherwise I would be thinning the paint out too much. Even though I enjoyed the fact that the layers underneath wouldn't reactivate, I actually think that's something that I've kind of grown to love with traditional gouache as well. It's definitely really challenging as a beginner to get the hang of it, but I like the fact that I can go back and re-blend areas, or I can control the amount of water on my brush and use it to my advantage. Whereas with acrylic gouache, once it's dry, that's it, you can't reactivate it again. So I have to change my blending techniques a little with acrylic gouache because I have to learn to work faster before the paint dries on the paper. It's definitely one of the major pros of this medium, but it can also be a drawback for the reasons I just mentioned. It really just depends on how you prefer to use your paint. If you don't like the fast drying properties of acrylic, then you might not enjoy using acrylic gouache. You can see here that when I go back in with a wet brush and try to reactivate the dried paint on the palette, it starts to peel off the palette and go all funny. That also means that you need more palette space because you can't keep laying fresh paint on top of those dried areas, because if you're thinning it down with water, it's going to cause that dry paint to start to peel. In terms of addressing my initial hesitations towards acrylic gouache, I would say that it's actually better than I expected. The paint was relatively easy to clean off my palette. I could easily scrape it off, or I could probably even just use water to soften it and get it off. Whereas with acrylics, it's usually a lot harder for me to clean the palette. And also when I wash the brushes, I feel like the acrylic gouache washed out quite easily. It definitely feels a lot softer on the brush than acrylic paint usually is when I'm washing it out of a brush. So all in all, I would actually say that I enjoy using acrylic gouache, even though I had so many initial hesitations towards it. And while I was painting the sunflowers, I actually wasn't enjoying the process. But after this, I painted a second painting because I wanted to get more of a feel for it before I talked about how I felt about it. And in that second painting, I actually already started to like acrylic gouache more. I could definitely see the advantages of using it with traditional gouache. For example, using the acrylic gouache to lay in the dark backgrounds underneath, and then using traditional gouache to continue the painting on top without having to worry about the layers underneath mudding. Something else that I think could help with the experience of using acrylic gouache is using a stay wet palette. That way you're not wasting as much paint on your palette and it's less stressful trying to keep your paints in your palette wet. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed watching me try acrylic gouache for the first time. I definitely will be painting with it more and experimenting a lot more with it, so there'll be more future videos with me using this paint. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye!